Hello everybody, I am E. Krishnarao Patro, Associate Professor in the Department of CSE. Today, we will discuss about one important concept, that is how to search an element from a linked list. So, the linked list is a collection of some nodes. The node may have some data. So, now you may try to search a particular item from the list. Whether it is available or not, you have to check. Now, you have to implement this one. Let us assume I have taken some example. I am having a linked list with following data 10, 20, 30, 40 and finally pointing to null. That indicates it is the end of the list. Now, from this list, in this list how many are there? There are 4 elements. There may be sometime thousands of node. There will be 1000 different type values. From this you want to search. So, here I may interested to search whether 20 is available or not. Yes, 20 is not available in the first list, not available in the first node, it is available in the second. Yes, it is found. But if I insert 45, then here what I will do? I will go to first node, then I check whether equal or not. If it is not available, go to second node. Then I will check whether both are equal or not. If both are equal, I will stop it. If both are not equal, then I will go to next node. Now 30 is not equal to 45, so I will go to next node. 40 also not equal to 45. Then I reach end. So whenever I reach end, still the data is not available. Then I will say not found. Not found. So now you have to implement this program. So this program, either you can write iterative way or you can write even recursive way. So both ways are exist. So you can implement in any other way. You can solve either using iterative technique. Iterative means the loop, or using recursion. Both ways are available. And the time complexity will be in the best case order of 1, because sometimes the data may be available in the first place itself. This is the best case. Sometimes data may be somewhere in the middle or at the end, or it may not be available. So, it has to traverse from beginning to till end. So, in that case, it is order of n. This is average or worst case. So, you have to consider both the case, average case as well as worst case. So, this is the time complexity. So, most of the time they will ask in the exam, what is the time complexity for searching a data from the linear linked list? One is order of n, second is one is order of one in the best case. Second is order of n in the best, average or worst case. Now, the algorithm, how will you write for this? Iterate the linked list using a loop. If any node has a given key value, return 1. If the program execution out of the loop, that means if not available, then you say it is not found, return -1. So, you can write this way also. Now, we will write a program for this. Let us go to our idle environment. IDLE. Yeah. There, I can type the program. Let us open a new file. New file. So, first of all, your duty is create a node first, because in a linked list there are set of nodes class node. In every node you will have two path, data path as well as the link path. So the data path you will write in your constructor itself. So I will write here def underscore underscore init underscore underscore, and self is the keyword followed by the data, because without construction of the node you cannot do anything. So first of all you have to construct a node first, and whenever this constructor is called, then you write here self dot data equal to the data itself. Okay, and in every node you will have data path as well as the link path. So self dot next self dot next is none. Initially, what is the next node? You are not aware. That's why I put a none value. Okay. So here, what happened? My node is ready. This node I will use whenever my linked list is created. So before searching the data, first of all, I have to create the linked list. So I'll write a class called linked list. In every linked list, you must end with a, means every class ends with must be colon. Now here I'll write def underscore underscore init self comma. Here I will not pass anything. Self dot, I will make a head pointer. Initial head is none. In every linked list, there must be a starting pointer. That starting pointer is called head. So I will assign to head is none first. This is my, when that means whenever the linked list object is created, this init method will be called and head will be initialized with the none. Then I have to insert the data. So I will write here def insert data. So my data is inserted. So I will write here self comma data. Remember, self must be given in the every function because it must be member of the each class. Now whenever the data is passed through this method, then here I have to call my this one. So new node I will create. My new node is created equal to node with data. Once the new node is created, that node I have to attach to my list. So whenever data is passed through this insert method, my node is created now. Now you have to insert at the end of the linked list because I have to insert because I will follow a linear order. First of all, whether you are inserting first time or second time, so I have to check. I will check a condition if self dot head. So whenever you want to access any member, then you have to use this dot operator. Self dot head, if it is equal to none, if this condition is true, this indicates you are coming for the first time. So you can write here self dot head equal to the new node. Otherwise, if it is not first time, that means second time onwards, come to else part. Here I have to traverse till end because when the new node comes, I have to go to till end, then I have to insert. That's why I will take a temporary pointer t equal to self dot head. So I do not want to disturb my starting pointer, my head pointer. So head will be assigned to t. Then here I will put a condition while t dot next. If t dot next is true, then I will go here. Then t should move forward because every time t has to go forward. So t equal to t dot next. Once reach end part, means end of the list. So the now t is pointing to the last node. T is pointing to last node. So now t dot next equal to new node. T dot next equal to new node. So automatically my new node is now pointing to next. Once attachment is over, then I will say data inserted. So here I can print a message print. Of course, whether if or else, in both the part I will write here print data inserted. Print data inserted. This message I have to simply display. Just simply signifying a message. Yes, data is now inserted into a new node. Means into the list. Now, once the data is over, means insert is over, let me write a display method also. Def display method. Now display method is my member method. So whenever you want to make this a member method, then you write here self keyword. If you are not writing self, that is not a member of the class. So in object oriented programming in Python, you have to use the keyword called self. Okay. Now, for displaying the all the data, I will write here t equal to self dot and I got the starting address. Okay, I will put a condition while t, if t is available, that means if t is not none, or you can put a condition if t is not none. This also you can write, both ways correct. If t is not none, then here I will come down, print percentage d percentage t dot data. So you can display the data also like this. Now after displaying the data, t equal to t dot next, because every time it should move forward, t dot next. So I have to assign that address. So t equal to t dot next. So before that, simply print a message. Yes, print the data, the data list. It is simply displaying the message. And after displaying the text, to put an arrow mark symbol. This is a significance. And when the loop is over, and I will put a end of the list, generally that is printed by a cross mark symbol. Cross mark, that indicates end of the list. So this is a simple program for only displaying all the data. But here now our goal is not displaying all the data. Our method is now to set a particular data, whether data is available or not. Here what I will do, I will write a separate method, def sets. Sets. And it is a member method of the class. So I will write here self. Self followed by the data. Now, my data, I want to check whether this data is available in the list or not. So for that what I will do, I will take a temporary pointer, t equal to self dot head. Okay, I got the starting pointer, because always in the linear, means in the linked list, always you have to start from head part. So I will not disturb the heading part. That's why I'm taking in a temporary pointer t. So I got the heading. So here I'll put a condition while, of course here I have to put a condition whether t is none or not. If self dot head, if it is not none, then I'll go there. Self dot head is not none, then I will search. If it is none, then you can say list is empty, you cannot search. So here I will take a temporary point now, t. Okay, t is already available. While t dot data not equal to your data, then continue. Or while t, I will continue. Here I will check if t dot data equal to my required data, if both are equal, if both are matching, then I will say data form. If this condition satisfies, then I print a message, print data form. Okay. Whether it is found or not, then I will move forward. If it is not found also, t equal to t dot next. But here, what I will do, whenever data found, no need to repeat the loop. So here I will make one flag equal to 1. That means found is 1. Then immediately I break the loop. No need to repeat the loop. Otherwise, what will happen? Unnecessary time will be wasted. So instead of going till end, I will break there itself. Else, t equal to t dot. here else I'll print a message print list is empty. List is empty. Because every time you have to check whether list is empty or not. If list is empty, you cannot display anything. If list is having some data, then you can go ahead. So here, please observe here in the while loop, I kept one. If it is available, it is going. Sometimes data may not be available. Still you may go end, but still data not found. So that's why what I'll do. Here I'll make flag equal to initial is 0. So flag equal 0 means it indicates that data not found. So whenever this loop is over, still this condition is not matching. Whenever this condition is not matching, it indicates what? Still data not found. So when the loop is over, by that time my flag value will be either 0 or 1. If it is 1, data found. If it is 0, if flag equal 0, then here I'll put a message data not found. Printf data not found. So this flag variable is my indicator whether data is available or not available. That's why I kept here. Initially flag is 0. So initially I believe that it is not available. But while in iterating the loop, there may be data found. If it is found, then break it. Sometimes the data may be available multiple times. But if it is available first time itself, in the first node itself, stop it. Sometime the list may have same data multiple times. But once it is found, I made it flag 1, then break it. Okay. So, but if the data is not matching, it is not found at all, then simply the loop is keep on going. Whenever t become null, it come out. By the time, the flag is 0 only. So once the loop is over, it will check whether flag is 0 or not. If it is 0, it will say data not found. If it is 1, already it says data found. Okay. So now, set method is now ready. Now this method is trying to search. Now here what I will do, I will create the object. Create the object of linked list class. Now my class is linked list. So here I will create the object obj equal to linked list of this. So my linked list is ready. Fine. Now your goal is you have to insert some data. So obj dot insert, but what is the name of the method? The name of the method is insert data. So whatever the name you have given, that name you have to call, because if the name is not matching, that will give compiler error. So insert data, assume I am inserting 10. Again I am inserting, assume 20. And I am inserting again 30. Again I am inserting 40. Again I am inserting 50. Once the data is inserted, then I will display. So obj dot display. Display. My name of the method is display. So I will call gen dot display. So this method simply display. Now let us display first whether it is available or not. Control S sets now F5. Yeah. Now data inserted, but it is coming in multiple line, but it has to come in same line itself. So what you have to do? Now 5 time data inserted and the data list is displaying, but it is coming like in 5 different lines, but it should come in same line. So for that, what you have to do? Here I will write here comma and equal to space. Control S F5. Yeah, it has come to single line. Now our goal is to check. Now insertion is over and displaying is over. Now check the given data is available or not. So here I will ask the user print. Enter data. Data to be searched. The data D. Input. Enter data. Whatever data you want to search, just input it. But whatever the data you are entering, the data comes always in terms of string format. But this string format I cannot check now because my data is in integer format. Of course, here while inserting, I have inserted as integer 10. So here what I will do, I will convert into int of this. So my integer data I want to search. So obj dot search the data is my data D. Whatever data you want to search. So D I am passing through my method. Because search is my method, it is defined here. So here I am passing the data. This is my formal parameter, this is my actual parameter. So my actual parameter is D. Once the data given, it will check the entire list from beginning to till end. Yeah, enter the data. Assume I am entering sum 30. Now it has to say, yeah, data found. 30 is available. But sometime I may give some wrong data also. Means the data may not be available. F5. Assume I want to search 45. Yeah, data not found. That means it has gone from beginning to till end. It is not finding this particular number. That's what it's saying. So the time complexity for this is order of n. If it is not found. If it is found in the beginning itself, that is order of 1. So this way it works. Now same program you can write even in the recursive way also. This is whatever the way we written, this is iterative way. Now see, this is iterative. Iterative process. Same program you can write in a recursive way also. So recursive means what? Whenever you want to write the same method again and again, calling same method till end. So how will you write recursive way? Let us write on recursive way. Def recursive search. Recursive search. And this is also my member method. So I'll write here self and I'll pass the data, whatever data you want to check. If so here it has to pass the starting address. So here what I'll do, I'll pass my start pointer. Start if self dot if start is null, start equal to none, then here I'll say that data not available. Print. Simply I'll say return here because it has to come out from the recursive. Because in the recursion what will happen, it will be calling same method and again else. If start of data equal to my given data, if both are available, both are equal, then I will print a message data found. Print data found, then return. Control should come out. If you are not writing return, what will happen? It may go for again further. So I do not want to go further, I have to stop it. Else If at all, first time the data may not be in the same node. It may be available in the some other place. So here what I will do, I have to call same method again and again, because recursion means whenever the method calls itself. So what is the name of the method? Recursive search. So in the recursive search, I am pass my, the first parameter is my data, as well as I have to pass start of, because I have to go to next node. My next node will be next node's address. So start.next, go to next address. So always it will check the data available in the current node or not. If it is available in the current node, stop it, return. If it is not available, go to again next node. That's why I am writing here start of next. Okay. So here it is keep on going. And whenever reaching till end, it indicates that there is something wrong. So here I will print a message, data not found. Printf data not found. Okay. Now in the recursive search, it is keep on going. I am passing my data path as well as my start dot next. So now I will call my recursive search with data path as well as the next path. Let us, this is my iterative way, so I'll put comment this one. So here I will call same obj dot sets followed by my data d as well as my starting, so obj dot head, because I have to pass the starting. Enter the data, assume I am passing 20. Recursive is not defined. Recursive sets obj.recursive, I have to define it. My data d is there, obj.head is there. My obj.head, head is my starting pointer, recsets. I am passing self. Self is my starting node, data followed by the start pointer, str start, yes. So here I should call self dot, because it is a member method. Control S F5 data SM 30 I want to search. Yeah, data form. It is on, because while calling, you have to call this member method through self. Okay. Now assume here I will control S F5. Assume I want to search 35. Yeah, data not found. Because it is going till end, and whenever it says none, it is returning none. So that means you are able to implement both the way. One is recursive way, another is non-recursive way. Now you see, both the methods are very important. Search list. Yeah. So this way is iterative, whereas this is recursive. Recursive is one of the very, very important one. Most of the students, they are suffering how to write the recursive way. And in the recursive, you must be very careful what condition to terminate. This is the condition for termination. See, I kept this condition. If it is none, then you have to stop it. If this condition is not written, what will happen? It will be going for infinite loop. So to avoid this infinite, put in this condition so that automatically it will stop it. Whenever it's a return, what will happen? Because whenever it's a recursion, internally it will be using one stack. So whenever the function is calling, it will push into the stack. If you are calling 10 times, it will push 10 times. And whenever we say return, it will be pop out. It will be popping out. So whenever popping out, then it will stopping the process. Otherwise, it will go for infinite. So whenever infinite process comes, there may be a runtime error. Stack overflow situation may come. That's why to overcome the stack overflow, always put a proper termination condition. So this condition I kept here. This is one way. Another one is, after finding the data, if the data is available, then put this condition also, data found, then return it. If sometimes data may not be available in the first node, it may be available in the next node. So that's why again you have to call here recursive search with data with startup nest. So that means every time I'm calling data with startup nest. So startup nest means I'm going to next node's address. So always I'm passing what? While calling, you must be very careful here. While calling, I'm passing my head node. My head node nodes, first node's data, first node's address. So after going to first node, I'll check whether data is equal or not. If it is not equal, I'll go to head up next. Head up next means second node. If it is not available, now again go to next. So it is keep on going till end. So this way you are able to. So that means this program is recursive way. Sorry, first one is iterative. First one is iterative. And second one is recursive. In the recursive way, we must be very careful what are the parameters to pass. So here I am passing my data as well as here I am passing my head pointer. Why head pointer is necessary? Because head pointer every time it has to update. Whereas in the case of iterative, you are putting in a loop to update the head. So you are writing t equal head and t equal t up next. It is keep on updating. Whereas here in the recursion, you have to pass that as a parameter. Every time whenever the condition not matching, it will go to next. It will go to again next and next. So till end, it will be traversing. But this is a little bit time consuming because it takes extra time for pushing and popping. Takes extra time for pushing and popping. Recursion is slow. Recursion is slow because of push and pop. Because of push and pop operation. Whereas in the case of iteration, there is no pushing and popping. It is repeating there itself. But the code will be easy to understand here. Recursion will be more easy. Okay. So this way you can write both iterative as well as recursive way. Sometime in exam, they may ask only recursive way, or sometimes they may ask only iterative way. Or if they ask both, you should be ready to write. And this part also you can write dynamically. You can read the data, you can pass whatever data you need. Here in this example, I have taken only these 5 static, but you can read the data dynamically and edit. Of course, here also, just like control C, assume I may put like this, read the data. How many? Assume here I did n data, n number of data. I am putting here n. So here I will put a loop while n greater than 0, the loop will continue. And inside the loop, what I will do? Again, I will read the data. The data equal to this. So I'm reading data. After reading data, then I'll call the method obj.insert the data. Then I'll remove this. So no need to write multiple insert statement. Single insert statement is enough, but you are writing the loop here, but n should reduce. N equal to n minus 1. Every time n I am reducing. Initially assume n is 5. So it will repeat 5 times. Enter data. Whatever data you are entering, it will push. And n is reducing. Whenever n becomes 0, come out. Now let us see how it works. F5. How many data? Assume I want 5 data. Assume 11, 22, 44, 55, 66. Yeah. Now list is created. Now it is asking which data you want to check. Assume I want to check 33. Yeah, 33 is not found. Okay, At 3, not found. F5. Assume 5 data. 11, 22, 33, 44, 55. Now, I want to check 44. Yeah, data found. Data found. It is coming 2 times because one in recursive way, one in non-recursive way. Both ways it is searching. So, you can write either recursive way or non-recursive way. Now, this way, you can write the program. And this is the best way of writing. Instead of writing static way, you can put this condition. How many data you want? And that many times the loop has to repeat. After reading data, display the data. It will display all the content. Then, which data you want to search? Read the data. And that data you pass to this method. And that method will tell whether data is available or not. So, of course, don't write both. You write either recursive or non-recursive. So, for the timing, I'll put this comment. Okay. So, this way you can solve it. 5 data. Assume I want to search 40, 55. Data form. Fine. So, this way you can solve the problem. And the best way is iterative way for this type of searching. Recursive, it is taking less code but takes more time because of push and pop operation. And you must be very careful while searching the data. And this flag variable is essential to say whether data found or not. Because using this flag, it is coming out. So, you must be ready how to create a linked list and how to search in both recursive as well as non-recursive. And remember the linked list init method, which is initializing the object, and insert method to insert the data. I am inserting the data at the end. Okay. You can insert at the end or you can insert at the beginning also. Both ways are correct. But here I am inserting at the end. Similarly, I wrote another method called display. This method for displaying the all the data. Whatever data you have inserted, you can display. And here you wrote your searching method. It's an iterative way of searching whether data is available or not. Fine. And there is another way, a recursive way. So, this is a simple way to search. So, you can follow either recursive or non-recursive way. So, practice well so that you can do this program easily. This is one of the simple program and easy program. Okay. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.